Let's speak to Owusu Warai. He's TV3's correspondent in terms of when it comes to issues of entertainment in and around the world. Owusu Warai is on top of it. He's joined us in studio. He was at the auditorium to tell us what he saw and from his perspective of, as a journalist and someone who's covered these two artists for years, what he makes of the whole brouhaha. All right, good afternoon and thank
good
you
afternoon,
for
Martin.
Joining us. You clearly are as worried as many fans of good music in Ghana. What, in your opinion, happened?
All right, so yesterday we had a wonderful evening. Awards were won, people picked them, and it was all exciting until it got to the time to announce the winner of the Reggae Dancehall Artist of the Year. And when you talk about reggae dancehall, it gets a lot of attention in Ghana, and you realize that we have two main blocks, Shatawale and Stoneboy. And so for you to affirm your credibility, you need to win that.
At least that particular category.
Yeah. So that was the main award both of them came for. And so when Abeg was about mentioning the winner of that very category, you could see that everybody was eager to know where he was going, and they mentioned Stoneboy's name. So at that moment, everybody felt that it was 1-1 draw because Shatawale had earlier won the Dancehall Song of the Year, and
he had actually picked up two awards before this one. You
know. And then he wasn't around to pick
to
it.
Pick them, yes.
And then all of a sudden, we saw Shatawale move. We didn't know what he was going to do. People felt that he was going now because he felt that award
should have been his.
Yeah. And then he went on stage. And what happened from where I was monitoring the event, what happened was that as he approached where Stoneboy was, I realized Stoneboy's manager also came. He didn't understand why Shatawale should come on stage. And at the end of the day, you had your day, you had your moments, and nobody came on stage. So he approached them. I think that was where we had
the confusion.
We had the confusion and we had a commotion and it got out of hand. And at a point, the security men had to step in and then put two gentlemen and their camps to order.
Were shots fired?
No. But we saw a gun.
Okay.
Okay. A gun, Stoneboy pulling out a gun. There are two schools of thought. People have said that he brought the gun to the venue himself, and I've heard other arguments that it was handed to him by one of his team members. But whichever the case was, I think we had a very beautiful ceremony, 20th anniversary, and this was the perfect time to make a statement with what we do here, music, entertainment, and it's very unfortunate that things turned out to be.
Okay, let's look at the first school of thought that almost all the Shatawale fans seem to be pushing, that Shatta was going to congratulate Stoneboy on stage. When he was leaving his chair and heading towards the stage, what was his demeanor, his body language? Did he look like someone who was smiling or was going with good intentions, or it looked suspicious for the ordinary person looking at him?
All right, so we had a lot of people at the auditorium, at the venue, so it was difficult
to tell
how he looked like, his demeanor and all that. But you could see that his men, you know, Shatta movement, family, you know, these are very, very tough guys and they are very aggressive. Okay, so I think that is what got Black City to also intervene and then meet them and tell them to go. So from where we sat, I realized that these were built men and they are with Shatawale. They were going, I cannot tell whether they were going to congratulate Stoneboy or it was an attack. But what I can tell is that, what I can confirm is that these were men who looked very aggressive. And so I think that's the main reason why Black City also confronted them, because the security men were there, but nobody expected Shatawale to move.
Especially with that kind of entourage he was coming with.
Yeah, and people have spoken about the fact that we should take our security very seriously.
Definitely. We'll pick your thoughts on that as the interview goes on. The other concern that has been raised is that, where was Shatawale when he won the two awards? Was he in the auditorium?
Okay, he was not there.
He was not there.
He was not there. I realized that in the course of the awards, he came in and then he got everybody's attention. Mm. Okay, because Shatta Wale, Almighty Shatta Wale, had entered. He had won two awards. He wasn't around to pick the awards. And so when he came, it was a big deal, especially for his fans. Mm. That, their icon
was in the house.
Is in. And so he wasn't around for the first two awards, but he was around when Stoneboy was named the dancehall artist of
the year. Now, let's finish up with this interview and talk about whether or not this is the first time someone has been named and an opposing or a competing personality in that category has gone on to stage, quote-unquote, to congratulate him. Have we ever had that since you started covering the Music Awards?
Okay, so I have been covering VGMA for like 9 years now, 2010 coming down, and I have not seen
it's never happened before.
It could happen. We were having a discussion earlier. Shatta Wale, if you speak to people, they tell you that it was uncalled for. He shouldn't have gone there. If he wanted to give Stoneboy a thumbs up, he could have clapped for
applauded.
Him. Applauded him when he was named Dancehall Act of the Year. And one interesting thing is that that very category, it's very competitive. Mm. And so when you win, it's
a big statement.
It puts you out there as a man, as an authority when it comes to reggae, dancehall. And Stoneboy had won it 4 times continuous, 2015, 16, 17, and 18. And so Shatta Wale, here is Shatta Wale who has made a comeback and is now looking to
pick that particular award
from Stoneboy. And it went the other way. So very unfortunate, but
was there good security until that moment? Do you think everything was organized well until that moment?
Yeah, we spotted security men at vantage point, but what it took them an hour because
nobody was prepared for
nobody that. Knew that Shatta Wale was going to come on stage, and before that moment, almost all the award recipients received their awards, said one or two words, and then left. So very, very surprised. And we have to take our security very seriously and make sure that we don't also allow a lot of people on stage. It's been discussed time and again.
We will definitely talk about that part of why an artist is called, and it comes with his entire family. Yeah. We'll talk about that later on. But thank you very much, Owusu Warai. He is the head of entertainment here at TV3 and has covered a number of entertainment events across the country. And I would keep an eye on this development. There is yet to be a statement from the security agencies and from the organizers. Two awards were not given out on the night. And according to the MC for the night, that is Kwame Sefaka, he said that those two awards were not going to be given following the confusion on stage. So the organizers would organize a press conference and give reasons why they didn't give out those two awards, and then also give reasons as to or name who won it. And I will keep you posted on those developments.